Hi, my name is André de Waal. Maybe you know me of my books on high performance organizations or the HBO Center did some research in your company. Thank you for watching this video. I would like to talk to you about a very current topic, the quality of management. There has been a lot of management bashing the last few years. Managers are worthless. They only cost money and they destroy your company. Interestingly, the opposite is true. Lots of academics research show that actually the quality of management is the number one success factor for your organization. We call this type of manager the high performance managerial leader. And in this video, I'm going to discuss the characteristics of this kind of manager. There's a lot going on in the environment of organizations which they have to deal with. I'm thinking especially about megatrends. Those are things which have been coming for a long time and will have a big impact. Think about, for instance, the aging population, environmental issues, but also something like a skilled shortage in employees. And organizations have to deal with all these, I would say, threats. And not only deal with them, not only survive, but also then thrive. And in order for organizations to do this, they need excellent management. We at the HBO Center have looked at the past 15 years where we have been busy with organizations building high performance organizations. And we have especially looked at what kind of managers were able to transform their organizations into high performing ones. And therefore we can call them excellent managers. And we have found that these managers share the same principles, the same behavior. And in fact, you could say these people are both very good in leadership, but they're also very good in managing. And together we call them high performance managerial leaders. To go into more detail, if you look at those managers, on the one side they're very committed to the employees, to the clients, to the stakeholders, to the organization. They also make enthusiastic and appealing pictures of where the organization is going. And this is what we call leadership behavior. At the same time, they are very good at achieving results day to day, week after week, month after month. And that is what we call managerial behavior. Now these two behaviors, like I said before, they work together. And one time you will have a bit more leadership, next time you have a bit more managerial side. Just what the circumstances demand. And these two types of behaviors always come together as a pair. In fact, there are five pairs and we call them the five principles. And the first principle is about being future-oriented, painting this appealing picture of the organization in the future, making people enthusiastic of that's where we want to go. And at the same time, making sure on the managerial side that we will achieve this vision. Take the short-term hurdles, get your short-term goals, being very steadfast and disciplined in achieving this. Principle two is about informing, communication and dialoguing with employees. So these managers make sure that people know what's going on in the organization, what is going to happen, and they also involve them in important decisions, important organizational processes. At the same time, they make sure that this is not becoming an endless discussion. So at a certain moment after enough dialogue, they will say, stop, we will now make a fast decision. And then quick action taking, so that really things happen. Principle three is about improving yourself and others. This appealing picture of the future will probably require more skills for you, different skills for you. So these managers make sure that their people, but also themselves, will get enough training. Maybe training on the job, maybe outside training, but they will get the new skills required. And then the interesting part is that these managers will make sure that what you have learned here will be actually put into daily practice so that people become high performing in daily practice. It's very nice that you have had all this training, but if you don't put it into practice, then it's a waste of time and money. Principle four is about your focus, and it's being externally focused and internally focused. As a leader, you're externally focused. What is going on in the environment of the organization? What is going on in the industry? What are the trends and developments? The mega trends I was talking about, the disruptors which are coming to you. How do you deal with these? At the same time, you're very focused on internally. What is going on in the organization? Are there things which need to be improved or maybe have to be rearranged? How are you going to deal with those external developments together with your people? So that's the internal focus. Sometimes a bit more externally, sometimes a bit more internally. And then the fifth principle is about creative improvement. And you all know about continuous improvement, but continuous improvement is not enough. If you improve always in the same way, you shouldn't be surprised you always get the same result. For new, different results, you need to have creativity, thinking out of the box. But this should not be just up in the sky. You need fact, evidence-based management. So your improvement should be based on facts. What does the data tell you? Which direction should we go in? How is our creative improvement actually resulting indeed in real-time improvement? So these are the five principles. And the interesting thing is now during the Corona crisis, you already see these principles in practice being used. Let me give you an example. In the beginning of the Corona crisis, you saw managers very busy with putting out fires, making sure that the service to clients could continue, making sure that the organization survived, which is pure managerial behavior. But now, after all these weeks and several months, you see these managers start to think about the future. What kind of organization do we want to be? What have we learned the past months, which we want to continue in the next decades, maybe even? So they're thinking about the future, which is, of course, leadership behavior. So in conclusion, as I always say, it's not so much a case that we need less managers, but we need more excellent managers. We need more high-performance managerial leaders. Thank you for watching this video. If you would like to know more, I invite you to watch the other videos, maybe read my book, or visit the website of the HBO Center. Also, you can always send me an email. Thank you very much.